Hello students, in the previous class we have studied about types of relations, that is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. So today we will solve few problems based on the topic, that is types of relation. So this is exercise of NCERT book 1.1, first question: determine whether this relation is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Relation R in the set A. What is set A? 1 to 14 defined as xy such that 3x minus y is equal to 0. So R xy such that 3x minus y is equal to 0, that is y is equal to 3x. And the set A is 1, 2, 3 and so on, 13, 14. So it is easy to understand. First we write this relation R in roster form. So how we can write? Because relation R is a set of ordered pair XY. But where y is equal to 3x, that means if we will take x as 1, then what would be y? 3 times of x, 1, 3. When we will take x as 2, then y will be 6, 3, 2, just 6. When we will take 3, then y will be 9. When we will take x as 4, then y will be 12. 4, 3, just 12. But we can't take over here as 5. If you will take x as 5, then y will be 3 times of 5 is 15, which is not the member of this set A. So because of that, this is the roster form of relation R. Now we'll discuss all types of relations. That first is reflexive. Reflexive. As 1 belongs to A, this implies 1, 1 does not belong to R. We have seen if every element or any element is the image of itself, then this type of relation is known as reflexive relation. But now in this relation, element 1 is belonging to A, it is the member of A. But 1, 1 ordered pair is not the member of R. 1, 1 does not belong to R. Therefore, it is not reflexive. So this relation is not a reflexive relation. Second, symmetric. One three belongs to R. This implies 3, 1 does not belongs to R. For all 1, 3 belongs to A. 1 and 3 are the members of A. 1, 3 belongs to A. But if 1, 3 is belonging to R, 1, 3 ordered pair is the member of R. 3, 1 is not, does not belong to R. 3, 1 ordered pair is not there in the relation R. Therefore, it is not symmetric. Okay, not symmetric. Now, third type, transitive. Transitive relation. As, what is transitive relation? A relation in which if AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, that implies AC must belong to R. So as 1, 3 is belonging to R and 3, 9 belongs to R, but one nine does not belongs to R. See here, 1 3, this order pair is the order pair of relation. 3 9 is the order pair of the relation, but 1 9 is not any order pair in the relation. Therefore, this relation is not transitive relation. Therefore, it is not transitive relation. So, how you can write at last? It is neither reflexive, nor transitive, nor symmetric. Now, second problem. This is question number 6. I am taking few problems. Rest of the exercise you will try to do. So, solution of 6th problem. Show that the relation R in the set 1, 2, 3 given by R is 1, 2, 2, 1 is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. Let the set is A, we can represent it as A, and the relation R is 1, 2, 2, 1. It is having two ordered pairs, 1, 2 and 2, 1. So, we will check that this is reflexive or not. As 1 belongs to A, this implies 1, 1 does not belong to R. We know our relation is reflexive if A is image of A. A is image of itself. Here, 1 is the member of, 1 is the element of set A, but 1, 1 does not belong to R. 1, 1 does not belong to R. Therefore, it is not reflexive. Now, second, symmetric. As 1, 2 belongs to R, this implies 2, 1 belongs to R for all 1, 2 belongs to A. 1, 2 order pair is also in relation R. 2, 1 order pair is also in relation R. That means second is the image of first, 2 is the image of 1 and 1 is the image of 2. So therefore, this is symmetric relation. Therefore, it is symmetric. It is symmetric. Now, last is transitive. What is transitive? Again, I want to know, what is transitive relation? A relation, if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, that must imply AC belongs to R. So see here, if 1, 2 belongs to R, as 1, 2 belongs to R and 2, 1 belongs to R, but 1, 1 does not belongs to R. See here, first, second, first, they are belonging, but 1, 1 is, does not belongs to R, first and third, therefore, it is not transitive. So, what was the question we were required to show that this relation R in set 1, 2, 3 is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. So, we have shown it that this relation is symmetric but it is neither reflexive nor transitive. We will take one more problem. Show that the relation R defined in the set A of all polygons as R P1, P2 such that P1 and P2 have same number of sides is an equivalence relation. What is polygon? A closed geometrical figure which has three or more than three sides is known as polygon. So here, set A set of all polygon. And what is R? It is order pair of P1, P2 such that P1 and P2 have same number of sides. As P1, we can say, first we have to prove, we have to show in this problem that it is an equivalence relation. So first, we have to show that it is reflexive as P belongs to R. For all P belongs to A. Therefore, it is reflexive. Any polygon which is having, suppose 4 sides, 5 sides, 6, anyway, that will have equal number of sides to itself. Means every polygon is image of itself. So therefore, it is reflexive. Now, symmetric as P1, P2 belongs to R. This implies P1 have, what is the P1, P2? Have same number of sides. P1 have same number of sides to P2. Now this implies if P1 is having suppose 5 sides and that are equal to P2, so P2 will also have the same number of sides as P1. So this implies P2 have same number of sides to P1. So this implies P2, P1 belongs to R for all P1, P2 belongs to A. Therefore, it is symmetric. It is symmetric. See here, we have started that it is, if P1 is having number of sides equal to P2, then P2 must have same number of sides as P1. So therefore, P2, P1 belongs to R for all P1, P2 belongs to A. Therefore, it is symmetric. To show that this relation is an equivalence relation, we have to show that it is also transitive. Transitive. P1, P2 belongs to R and P2, P3 belongs to R. This implies P1 have same number of sides, to P2, and P2 have same number of sides to P3. This implies, see, if P1 is having suppose 5 sides equal to P2, which is also having 5 sides, and P2 is having same number of sides to P3, that is also P3 is having 5 sides, then the number of sides of P1 and P3 remain same. So this implies P1 have same number of sides to P3. This implies P1, P3 belongs to R. Why? Because R relation is ordered pair of P1, P2, which are having same number of sides. So therefore, P1, P3 belongs to R for all P1, P2 and P3 belongs to R. So this implies it is transitive. It is transitive relation. The relation which is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, that is known as an equivalence relation. So this implies this relation R is an equivalence relation. Why? Because it is reflexive in nature, symmetric in nature and transitive in nature. So we have proved the first part of this question. Now we will see the second part. What is the second part? What is the set of all elements in A related to the right angle triangle T with sides 3, 4 and 5? So let B is the set related to the right angle triangles. Let B is the set of all elements, set of all elements related to right angle triangles. So what will be with sides 3, 4 and 5? What is the set of all elements in A? We are considering that it is B is the set of all elements related to right angle triangles. So this implies B contains which polygons we will have? We will have the polygons which polygon is having 3 sides, because triangle is having 3 sides. So B contains all polygons having all polygons having 3 sides. All triangles. So we have shown in this problem that the given function is an equivalence, given relation, sorry, is an equivalence relation, and the set will contain all three sides or all triangles, the polygon having three sides, that is all triangles. That's all about this topic. You will try rest of the problems from the book. Thank you.